Namaskar everyone. I'm Sanskriti Kumar.
And I am Shivam Sharma.
Welcome to the podcast series of Kothari International School. Today, we have here with us the class 10 topper, Achal Mohanty. She has been awarded the award Medhavi Chhatra Samman and a cheque of Rs. 1 lakh by the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Shri Yogi Adityanath. Now, congratulations, Achal Mohanty, for scoring a whopping 99.4%. And congratulations for making us all proud.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me here.
So, we are the students of Grade 10. And today, we have the opportunity to learn the story of your success. Shall we begin?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So, we really want to know, what was your reaction when you first found out that you were the topper? And how did your family and friends react?
So I remember when the news came to our school that we were getting our board exam results that day. Everyone was just so excited and nervous. However, I was very calm because I knew that I would get good results. But when I found out that I got 99.4%, I was just out of my world. I couldn't stop myself from crying tears of joy. It was a very proud moment for both me and my family, my parents, my friends, and everyone was just really supportive and proud of me.
Oh, of course, it must be a very proud feeling in fact. So, can you walk us through a day in your life for your patients, and was it easy for you?
So, I used to wake up at around 8 o'clock, and then after I had had my hearty breakfast, I would start studying at around 9. I would solve PYQs or sample question papers, which would take me 2 to 3 hours. After that, I would take a short break, have my lunch, and I would start studying again at around 2. I would revise my theory, read my chapters, and read my notes, which would take me 2 hours. After another short break, I would start studying again at 6 o'clock. I would solve numericals, revise my formulas, and which would take me 2 hours. And after that, I would take a short break, have my evening walk, have my dinner, and then go to sleep.
Of course. So, being a student at Kothari International, we'd love to hear about how KIS helped your journey into scoring such good marks.
Well, of course, KIS has given me all the support that I need. The teachers here are so helpful and can give you advice anytime you need. Along with that, I really like the fact that Kothari does not have a strict competitive environment. We have healthy competition here in such a way that the teachers and the peers are really supportive of all the students here.
Also, many students struggle with balancing their extracurriculars and their academics. So how did you manage to excel in both of them?
See, the most important thing is to know what your goals are and to set specific goals which you can achieve easily. So the most important thing is to set a timetable, set a routine, and follow it with discipline.
I'm sure you must have followed it with discipline.
Yes, I did.
Yeah. So nowadays, we hear that 10th is all about studies. You cannot meet people, you cannot meet your friends or go outside. You basically have to cut down your social life. So is it really true? Did you have to sacrifice your social life?
No, it depends on the person. For me, my social life and my friends have been my biggest supporters throughout this journey. I don't know what I would do without my friends. However, it depends on you. If you feel and you believe that your social circle is hindering your progress and is distracting you, then friends wisely. If you believe that your social circle is hindering your progress or is distracting you, maybe you should take a step back and focus more on your academics at that time.
Right.
Now, coming to your preparation, did you find any subject or topic really challenging, and how did your teachers guide you?
Well, one subject that I, along with a lot of my classmates, found difficult at first was social science. I used to think that it was a subject where we just have to memorize facts. However, my social science teacher, Garima ma'am, she gave me personalized advice on how to solve social science problems. She told me to frame questions myself and then answer it myself so that I can learn more easily and efficiently. Along with that, I struggled with English and Spanish writing section. So my English teacher Amanda ma'am and my Spanish teacher Kunal sir advised me to make a rough column so that I can get a clarity on my thoughts.
I totally agree with you, Anshul. So recently you have been awarded the Medhavi Chhatra Samman Award by the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Shri Yogi Adityanath. How did you feel when you received the award?
So I remember when I got the call about the award, I was eating lunch and I could not believe my ears when I found out that I was getting awarded 1 lakh rupees for my excellent performance in the boards. So, and when I finally got to Lucknow and I got my award, it was such a wonderful opportunity and such a wonderful experience to live the dreams that I had been hoping for.
So Archer, as we are wrapping up this conversation, would you like to tell us something that we might have missed, or would you like to share something to everyone?
Well, as we come to an end of this, I would like to thank my school for supporting me and guiding me whenever I need it. I would like to thank Principal Ma'am, Vice Principal Sir and all my teachers for always helping me and being a great mentor. I would also thank my family and my friends for being a great support system throughout this journey.
Remember, it's just not about hard work, but also working smart and maintaining a positive mindset. As Anshul aptly highlighted, that staying motivated, managing stress, and seeking guidance whenever needed are crucial parts of this success. Now we hope that her story encourages you to pursue your dreams and goals with renewed vigor and determination.
As we wrap up this insightful conversation, it's clear that Anshul's journey to the top was marked by dedication, strategic planning, and an unwavering commitment to her studies. Her success story is not about scoring high marks, but about embodying a holistic approach to learning and personal growth. From the innovative study routines to the techniques and the balanced routine, thank you, Anshul, for sharing your experiences with us and your valuable advices. Your journey is a testament to what can be achieved with focus and perseverance. To all our listeners, we hope you found this conversation as inspiring and engaging as we did. Until next time, keep striving for excellence and believe in your potential to achieve great things. Thank you.